Okay, so it is December 23rd, 2009. We have Kaylee Bays. Okay, so Kaylee, would you please cross your arms over your chest? Come on in, Dr. Matt.
Hey, guys. Yeah. Sorry, I didn't mean to ruin your shot.
That's all right. and go ahead and start marching in place with your eyes open. Okay, and now close your eyes. Keep going.
That's actually the best she's ever done.
Well, that's really good.
I'll show you some previous footage.
Okay. Okay, so we see the internal rotation there on the left side, which is interesting. All right. Okay, so watch the center here, all right? Okay. And first just watch it come close. There, and watch convergence again. Yeah. Okay, right there. All right, and now just watch this. So that way, and then towards the right. Oh wow, it's already started to decrease. I wish I'd filmed it earlier.
Don't tell me you didn't film the. There's a little.
There is definitely
a lot less.
Yes, a lot less. Okay.
Wow.
Okay, now keep filming. Now we're gonna do Scott's here. So head straight again, and then look at this thumb, and this one. Oh my God. This one.
This is at least 50% improvement from.
No, it's like I'm killing myself that I didn't do the pre because it's like 100% improvement right now. So second time post Sakai training for the right cerebellum. So let's just use the to and fro again. So you're looking right here in the center. Okay, and then from here, and here, and here, and here. Wow. Now let's just retest the Fukada test. So, okay, so this is post neurological stimulation of the right cerebellum. Go ahead and, with your eyes open, start marching in place. And keep it that high, you know, just like that. And close your eyes. Wow. Barely internally rotating. And we should do the same thing again with the shoe lift off. Now as she goes longer, it starts to deviate a little bit, though. Okay, good.
Alright, yeah, so we're
going
to do 12 of these.
Go ahead.
Inhale.
Okay.
So
eyes open first, and then
just
do eyes closed.
Eyes open first, go ahead.
12 of those, and tempo with your breathing, okay? So as long as it takes you to inhale, all right, as slow as it takes to open, exactly.
Alright, and go ahead back to the start, and let's do it.
And then,
David just got real.
And then, eyes closed, go ahead.
Yeah, I didn't move that time. That's all right. There is a much better one.
All right.
Awesome. Great. Very nice. Come on in. Now we're going to do the Fukada test again with the lift of the shoes off. We could see the difference in the shoe lift size there. All right. So go ahead again. Cross your arms. Eyes open. Start marching in place. All right. And eyes closed. So now we could see the deviation. Well,
no internal rotation.
Yeah, not much internal rotation.
This is 20, like 75%, 90% better.
Really?
Than she's ever done.
Awesome. Okay, so now when we look at the brain, Kaylee, we've got different parts of it. We have parts that sit down here in the back, and that's called your cerebellum. Okay. And remember when I had your arm up like this, and I said resist as I push down, hold. That's a cerebellar response. When you resist, hold, it sends a signal which tells your body to make this muscle strong, okay? Now, on top of that, there's this little tent and a divider, and there's two halves on each side. You know, you have one side of the brain controls one side of the body, and opposite. And this is called your cerebral cortex. And that's the part that we were testing when I said, hold your arm up, and bite down, and push up into my hand. And there's nothing there. Now relax your jaw, and push up into my hand real hard. And it's nice and strong there. That's because where the compression is affecting frontal cerebral cortex, you have lack of initiation of motor movement when you bite down. That's that cranial dental compression that we're going to evaluate with the ICAT and have the dentist look at. So what we were just stimulating was the right part of your cerebellum. That's the reactionary force. And we did that by stimulating your eyes when you turn your head. And that helped to balance you out when you're walking. Now, don't go doing that exercise all the time yet until we see the changes, okay? And then we'll figure out how often, if necessary, we need to do that. All right?